are black, our teeth are falling out. We got spots on our back, so give it up and shout. We got scurvy, we need some vitamin C. We got scurvy, we need a lemon tree. We got scurvy, we just chillin' on the sea. Let's get this scurvy started. A pirate ain't worthy till we got some scurvy. Since you got your scurvy on, you unnerve me when you sing that song. Scurvy!
Scurvy!
We got scurvy!
Scurvy!
We got scurvy!
Scurvy!
We got scurvy!
The Industrial Revolution, hungry for goods, opened up the world to trade. But in the cramped world below decks lurked a disease that would take more than just fresh air to overcome. Scurvy was killing more men than enemy action. A huge array of treatments were being used haphazardly to try and tackle the condition. James Lind, a Scottish naval surgeon, proposed a new kind of trial to find out whether any of them actually worked. So, time to test these six proposed cures on these very sick-looking sailors.
Indeed.
They all look very sick. This is some cider for you. We're going to give you some seawater, sir. This is sulfuric acid. And this is a mixture of nutmeg and garlic and other things. Now we ought to give some vinegar. Now, we've got for you, sir, an orange and a lemon. And be careful that you eat all of these. It's a very valuable part of the ship's provisions.
The world's first controlled clinical trial demonstrated that one of the treatments had won hands down. Within a week, the sailors who had eaten the oranges and the lemons were fit for duty and were nursing the others back to health. Science had categorically proved Lynn's case, but the Admiralty was stuck in a different age. It ignored Lynn's findings for over 40 years, and thousands of sailors died needlessly.
Lethargy, skin spots, spongy gums. This man's got scurvy.
But we've only been at sea one day.
When's the last time you had citrus?
I had a mimosa at brunch a few years ago.